Welcome to Finchley College. This program is about setting out techniques and how the different methods of setting out you can choose depending on their situation. The first program is a setting out program. So setting out program is the main program to use, and the way it works is that you have your control axis plus north minus north plus east minus east. Supposing you've set up here with the easting of this point, with the easting of say 150 meters, northing of 250 meters, and you want to set out the point with the easting of say 170 meters and the northing of 290. So your first act in everything you do on site is that you do a free station program. And you will find out the east north z of the instrument, for example, easting 115, northing 250, height, for example, 0.5 or whatever it is. So once you find out where the instrument is, now you want to set out the point with these coordinates. So you go to the setting out program, so SO, setting out program. And on the setting out program, the first thing is to ask you, it will say set a job. Set station, set orientation, and then start. Now, because you've done a free station program, or if you're not set up on a known point, you just set up somewhere, and we've used a free station program, the job is set. You originally have told what job you want to store data, so the job is set. You go to the job, for example, say, job North London. So everything is stored in the North London job, for example. Set the station is done, there will be a tick in there, there will be a dot in there, done. Set the station is done because you've done the free station and the instrument knows the station. Set orientation is already done because the free station already automatically calculates the correct bearing for the instrument. So when you go to the setting out program, you can see already ticks in front of these three. These are done, so you don't need to worry. You go start. So you press enter for start. So when you go to start, the instrument at the moment may be pointing here, for example, and you want to set up this one. So the north is here. So the instrument draws the north parallel to the actual north. The instrument calculates the difference and the angle between what it is now and the north. And it will add to that, the bearing is calculated from the north to that point. So it will give you the actual angle to turn from where it's pointing at the moment to where it should be pointing to get to there. So for example, this is 20 degrees and this is 40 degrees. It will show you 60 degrees plus 60, i.e. turn me 60 clockwise. So you turn 60 degrees clockwise from where it's pointing now, and then all the distance, it will show you, for example, the distance 12.9 meters. So then you hold the target in here and you measure the distance, and if you're overreading, there will be a dimension here, arrow this way, come to you. For example, 1 meter. If you're too short, it will be arrow that way, away from you, and it will tell you how far to go back. When you measure the distance, when the difference between what is measuring and what it should be measuring is the same, then the difference is zero. When the difference is zero, that means you found the point that you're looking for. So that's when you put a pin in the ground, or you put a mark on the floor, the cross with the pen, or a pin in the ground in a field. So that's how you do setting out. You do a free station first, you find out where the instrument is set, and you simply give the coordinate of the point you want to set out to the instrument. So I want to set out point, for example, 1, with these coordinates. It will tell you simply how much to turn from where it's pointing at the moment, and what distance to measure. So you turn the instrument until the difference in angle is 0, between what it should be and what it is now. And you measure the distance. When the difference in what's measuring and what it should be measuring is the same 0, then that point is the point.